Since the AI outbreak, segregation of people and machines was inevitable. 90% of the world's resources is now controlled by the corporation. Data is centralized. Privacy is a luxury for the rich. Historical technology are forbidden. However, there are still a few of us out there operating outside the corporation's watch, in the shadows, in search of truth and wisdom, hoping one day they can throw the balance of power. We call them the Seekers.
我叫乔治，来自于未来的一名Seeker。如果你看到这个视频，说明我需要你的帮助。我剩下的时间不多了，今天是人类与智能机器爆发战争的第21天。
I don't have much time, but I think I've found something.
This is the SIRUI 35mm T25 Anamorphic 2nd Generation. It is the world's smallest and lightest full-frame anamorphic lens. This is the predecessor to the infamous SIRUI 35mm when it first released, with its affordable anamorphic range. And in its wake, encouraged more budget-friendly anamorphic lenses to be released to the public. Back then, I was reluctant to purchase the first edition, even though I really liked the look it produced. I just didn't have enough use for it to justify the purchase at the time. The weight was also a concerning factor, at over 900 grams. It would be too heavy on a gimbal or handheld for a sustainable film shoot, especially if you had to manually adjust the focus while shooting. However, unlike the first lens, this lens is even better. What you see now are footages straight from the SIRUI 35mm, still T2.0, still with a squeeze factor of 1.6, but with a slightly longer focal distance of 0.9 meters. But that's about the only similarity you'll find. At just 4.18 grams, it's nearly half the weight as its predecessor. To keep the weight down, it's made from solid aluminium construction and a touch of carbon. It uses a new arrangement of spherical lenses with tight internal arrangements, allowing for a more compact size. Unfortunately, the lens was only available in RF and E mounts, and at 58mm diameter, you would need some step-up rings for your matte boxes. But with the lens at this size, you can put on a gimbal, FPV, to get any cinematic aerial shots.
If you have only shot on spherical lenses and never had an opportunity with anamorphics, then you should definitely try.
I don't want to say it's better or worse to a spherical, that's subjective, but for me, it's the characteristics. It could be the overall bokeh in the background, or the vertical stretching of out-of-focus subjects, an anamorphic characteristic you often see in many Hollywood films. The subtle anamorphic flares reverberating as you parallax around your subject, and the 1.6x squeeze factor to achieve that cinematic widescreen perspective. The previous version flares were a bit too much. I wanted the anamorphic look, but didn't want the excessive flares. The occasional spill is welcome, but too much flare would dilute the image and take away from the story I'm trying to tell. SIRUI have slightly toned down the flares. In fact, unless you're in direct sunlight or at low light with high contrast, it's hard to really see the flares. Now, there are still some spill from the side if you have the lens angled towards the emitting light, but it's controllable with a matte box. This version comes in both blue and neutral flares. I got the blue flare, but if you're unsure, I will suggest the neutral to reflect the light source in your shot. With no stabilization and being so light, you really need to have it on a tripod or a gimbal. Handheld shots tend to be shaky unless that is the style you're going for. SIRUI makes sharp lenses, and this one is no exception. I personally don't prefer over sharp lenses, as I'm always trying to imitate that film look with imperfections and blurred edges. You could add a black mist filter on top or just correct it in post. At 58mm, it's relatively cheap to find a good black mist filter. I guess being sharp gives you the option to reduce it in post, and that's not possible vice versa. Add in a couple of my LUTs, convert it to Rec 709, and you've got yourself a buttery footage for your next short film.
35mm is a lens I can use to shoot an entire film on.
Although the lens is 35, de-squeeze it and it becomes equivalent 22mm. You're able to capture the subject and its surroundings and how they interact with each other. But of course, you also have the option to frame block and focus on the subject. Because the focal distance is 0.9, you would need a close-up filter. The one I have is 4x. You do lose the infinite focus, but you are able to focus on your subject a lot closer. I remember back in the days, the lens was paired with the Sony S3 or the FX3 at night, and it was a crazy combo. Low light capabilities and anamorphic flares. And surprisingly, at wide open, you can even take some interesting photos. If I had to choose one lens to take part for a short film, this would be the one. My name is George, a seeker from 2048. If you hear this message, it means we need your help. Please like and subscribe.